Does the purchase cost of the inventory you sell constantly change? Well, you'll learn how to deal with changing purchase costs in this video when we discuss the weighted average inventory costing method. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Changing purchase costs can be a challenge when you're trying to track your cost of goods sold to subtract it from your sales income to determine your profit. Purchase cost of items sold, as you know, get recorded in the cost of goods sold account. QuickBooks needs to know the purchase cost of the items that were sold in order to be able to calculate the amount of cost of goods sold for that particular sale. If all purchase costs always stay the same, then QuickBooks will always know how much to put into the cost of goods sold account when you sell your merchandise. Unfortunately, if purchase costs change on new items purchased, then you have different purchase costs for the same item in inventory, and that's the problem. The problem is, if you have different costs for the same item, the question is, how does QuickBooks know which costs to use when you sell an item and need to find the cost of goods sold for the items that were in that sale? For example, let's imagine on April 1, you have 3 apples in your inventory that you previously purchased for $10 each. Now let's imagine on April 2nd, you purchased 2 more apples, each for $12. Now here's where the interesting part comes in. On April 3rd, you sold 3 of them. Which 3 did you sell? They all look alike when they're sitting in the bunch. And then if you don't know which particular 3 apples you sold, then what costs get assigned to those apples for you to determine the cost of goods sold to subtract from your sales for that particular sale? That's the issue. Well, QuickBooks Desktop uses a special accounting method called the weighted average method. It's the average of all of the different costs that you paid for the item with consideration to the quantity of the item after each step. So, let's first discuss what a normal average is. Let's imagine you have 1 apple for $10, 1 apple for $12, and 1 apple for $14. If these were the 3 apples sitting in your inventory, then you know you paid a total of $36 for each of those 3 apples, and you know that the normal average cost for those 3 separate costs would be $12. And then you could use $12 as the cost of goods sold for the apples that went out. However, you would not normally use the normal average because that only considers the different costs without considering the quantity purchased at each cost. The weighted average method considers quantity in the average. So, let's imagine we have 1 apple for $14, 1 apple for $12, and we have 3 other apples that we previously paid $10 each. Now, we have way more of the $10 apples. So you can't just add 10 plus 12 plus 14 and divide by 3, because you're not considering that most of the apples were purchased for $10. So you have to factor this into your average, and we still have 3 different prices, but we have more of the apples that were purchased for $10. So you can't just add them up and divide by 3 and use the number 12 as your cost of goods sold, because the real average would have to be closer to 10 because you have way more at the $10 cost. So here are the steps to finding the weighted average so that you can assign a cost of goods sold to the items when you sell. Step 1, find the total quantity. Well, that's pretty easy, especially if you're using a computer. Step 2, add all the costs of all the items together to get the total cost. And of course, step 3, divide by, use division, divide cost by quantity, and then you will have come up with a weighted average for each individual apple that you could then use as the cost of goods sold the very next time you sell. So if this were the situation and we sold 3 apples, the cost of goods sold for that sale would be 3 times the $11.20. Notice it's a little bit closer to $10 than the original $12 regular average that we had, because if we have more at the lower cost, that tends to pull down the weighted average. Now let's try a second example just to make sure you got it before we go over to QuickBooks. Let's imagine in inventory right now, we have 5 apples at $13 each, 8 apples at $18 each, and 3 apples at $16 each. Now we know that the weighted average should be a little closer to 18 than anything else, because you have 8 apples at the $18 purchase cost each. So the total quantity is easy to calculate, and the computer will give you that. But this is displayed a little differently. So how would you get the total cost? 5 apples. Well, what you would have to do is find the cost of each separate purchase and add it together. So for the 5 apples that you purchased at $13, you would multiply and find those 5 apples cost you $65 to buy. For the 8 apples that you purchased at $18 each, those 8 apples cost you $144. And for the 3 apples that you purchased at $16 each, they cost you $48. So these apples together in total cost you $257, and there's only 16 of them. So then when you divide, you come up with a result that's $16.06, and that is the weighted cost of each unit, the weighted average of each cost. And it would be that number, $16.06, that you would multiply by the quantity whenever you sold to find the cost of goods sold for that particular sale. Now let's see this in action in our QuickBooks file. Right now in our inventory, if you've been following along properly, you should have 273 apples physically available for sale. And your report should show that you paid $10 to purchase each of those 273 apples worth $2,730 altogether. So, what if we purchased 100 more apples, but we purchased them at $12 each? What would happen? Well, what would be the new cost per apple that QuickBooks would give us? Right now we have 273 apples at $10 each, making $27.30 for the money amount of our apple inventory. If we bought another 100 apples at $12 each, that means we'd be paying $1,200 more for those 100 additional apples. And we know the total quantity after that purchase would be 373, and we know the total purchase cost of all apples after that purchase would be 3,930. Therefore, the weighted average per apple would be $10.54. So if we recorded this purchase, QuickBooks would then show us the new unit cost per apple in the report that we just showed a moment ago, but it would not say $10. It would say $10.54. And that means that any subsequent sale would have $10.54 assigned to the cost of the apples to calculate the cost of goods sold for that particular sale. So let's record that purchase. Let's imagine on May 2nd, 2019, we paid Sam's Farm $1,200 for 10 apples, 100 apples, $12 each. Well, it's very simple. Banking, write a check. And we said that was May 2nd of, we're doing 2019. Might as well do it right. We bought it from Sam's Farm. And no, we're not using a past purchase order. And yes, we're still writing a check. Don't worry about those two pop-ups. But do not fill in the money amount. Go to the items, choose apples, and the quantity is 100. However, we are changing the purchase cost from 10 to 12. Now, it's going to ask you, should we update with the new cost? No, because this might just be a fluke. Who knows? Or you might want to say yes if you really feel that it's a permanent change. But the point is, we're buying 100 apples for $12 each, and we're paying Sam's Farm $1,200. Now, after we click Save and Close, we're going to open the inventory valuation detail. Ha ha! The new cost for Apple as of May 2nd is now $10.54. That means when we sell apples right now, the amount of apples or the quantity of apples that we sell will be multiplied by 1054 in order to calculate the cost of goods sold. So let's sell with the new cost. On May the 4th, we sold 10 apples to Candy and received cash. Let's talk about this. The sales income will still be 500 because the sales price each apple is 50 and we're selling 10 of them. So 500 is coming in. How much will be the cost of goods sold? How much does QuickBooks say that we paid for the apples that for the 10 apples that we just gave Candy? Well, QuickBooks is going to tell us that we paid $10.54 for each of the 10 apples that we just gave Candy. And therefore, if we're selling 10 of them, that means $105.40 is the amount of cost of goods sold for that sale. Let's see if that's what QuickBooks does. We click Sale Receipt and change the date to May the 4th be with you. Now we're selling to Candy and we're selling her apples. Now the sales price certainly didn't change. So if we're selling 10 apples, we know that's 500 in income. But after I click Save and Close, I can open the trial balance and I can see if I go to sales and double click the sales number, yes, $500 in income for sales. However, if I go to the cost of goods sold account and double click and go down to the most recent sale receipt here on May the 4th, you can see that the amount of cost of goods sold for that sale that we just recorded is exactly the number we expected, $105.36.